Greetings and welcome to Practical Ninjas. In this video, we will be learning about resistors. Resistors are passive components that are widely used in electrical and electronic circuits. But what is exactly a resistor or resistance? Resistance, as the name suggests, is something that opposes flow of current. Resistance of a conductor can be calculated if the length of the conductor, its area of cross-section, and the resistivity of the conductor's material is known. Suppose the length is L, cross-section area is A, and the resistivity is rho, then the resistance R of the conductor is given as R equals rho into L divided by A. From the formula, we can infer that the resistance is directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to the cross-section area. Increasing the length increases the resistance. The unit of resistance is ohms. This brings us to Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage applied across the conductor and is inversely proportional to the resistance of the conductor. Mathematically, it is written as V equals I into R, where V is the voltage and I is the current. To understand voltage and current clearly, check the video link for the same in the description. Using Ohm's law, we can find out the equivalent resistances across two terminals. Let us try to find out the equivalent resistance when resistors are connected as seen here. This kind of connection is called as a series connection. As seen here, the second resistor is connected to the first resistor at its N terminal. In series connection, the current flowing through the first resistance passes through the second resistance as there is no other path. If the resistance values are R1 and R2, then by Ohm's law, the voltage across R1 and R2 will be V1 equals IR1 and V2 equals IR2. The total voltage applied will be V equals V1 plus V2. V can be equated to I into R equivalent, where I is the total current and R equivalent is the equivalent resistance of the circuit. This V can also be equated to IR1 plus IR2. Comparing both the equations, we get R equivalent equals R1 plus R2. The same formula can be extended to N resistances in series, and its equivalent resistance can be calculated as R equivalent equals R1 plus R2 plus till Rn. This is called series equivalent resistance. Now, consider the circuit shown in the figure. Here, the resistances are connected on both the ends. This type of connection is called as parallel combination. In the parallel combination, the voltage applied across the terminals of resistors remain same. However, current through the resistors change. Let the total current be I, and I1, I2 be the currents through R1 and R2 respectively. The voltage across resistors is V. Then, I1 equals V by R1 and I2 equals V by R2. Suppose R equivalent is the parallel equivalent, then I equals V divided by Req. We know that I equals I1 plus I2. This gives us 1 upon Req equals 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. This is the parallel equivalent resistance. The same formula can be extended to N resistances in parallel. 1 upon Req equals 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 till 1 upon Rn. Hope you have understood the working of Ohm's law and how to find out the equivalent resistances for series and parallel combinations. That's it for this video. Subscribe and press the bell icon to stay updated on the new videos. Until next time, stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.